The question given is the crank and connecting rod of a vertical petrol engine running at 1800 rpm are 60 mm and 270 mm respectively. The diameter of the piston is 100 mm and the mass of the reciprocating parts is 1.2 kg. During the expansion stroke, when the crank has turned 20 degrees from the top dead center, the gas pressure is 650 kilopascal. There are four things to determine. First is the net force on the piston. Second is the net load on the gudgeon pin. Third is the thrust on the cylinder wall. And fourth is the speed at which the gudgeon pin load is reversed in direction. So first of all, we have been given as vertical engine. So it will be like this. This is a slider. This is line of stroke. This is connecting rod. And this is crank. So we have been given the crank length as 60 mm or 0.06 meter. So R equal to 0.06 meter and connecting rod length is 0.27 meter. So N equal to L by R equal to 0.27 upon 0.06, that will be equal to 4.5. And we know that in case of vertical engine, the net load F on the slider is given by F equal to pressure force minus inertia force minus friction force plus mg. They didn't have talked about friction force, so we can term it as 0. So it will be equal to Fp minus Fi plus of mg. Now diameter given to us is 100 mm, so area will be pi by 4 into 0.1 square, that will be equal to 0.007854 meter square. Now Fp will be equal to pressure into area, that will be equal to pressure given to us is 650 kilopascal. So 650 into 1000 into 0.007854, that will be equal to 5105.1 newton. Now inertia force is a mass of reciprocating part or mass of slider into A. That will be equal to mr omega square into cos theta plus of cos 2 theta upon n. Now they have given that crank, when the crank has turned 20 degree from the top dead center, so it will be rotating like this. Crank is rotating like this. This is top dead center and this is bottom dead center. So they have said that when the crank has turned 20 degree from the top dead center, means initially crank was here, now it has turned 20 degree from the top dead center, so theta will be equal to 20 degree. So putting theta equal to 20 degree in this equation, below equation, we will get, and mass of the reciprocating parts they have given is 1.2 kg, and rpm they are given is 1800 rpm. So omega equal to 2 pi into 1800 divided by 60, that will come out to be 188 0.5 radian per second. So putting all these things into inertia equation, we will get 1.2 into r. R we have been given as 0.06 into omega square, that is 188.5 square, into cos theta, that is cos 20 plus cos 40 divided by 4.5. That will come out to be 2839.54 newton. So F is equal to Fp minus Fi plus of Fg. Fp we have calculated as 5105 and Fi we have calculated as 2839.54 plus of Fg 1.2 into 9.81. That will be equal to 2277.23 newton. So net effective load is 2277.23 newton. So first they have asked net force on the piston, so we have calculated net force on the piston. Now we will move on to the net load on the gudgeon pin. So net load on the gudgeon pin is nothing but equal to the force in the connecting rod. So this is slider, this is line of stroke, this is connecting rod, this is crank. Net load is this F, that is equal to 2277.23. Now this is FC and this is beta. To calculate FC, first we have to calculate beta. So we know that this is 60 and this is 270. So by sine rule, 60 upon sine beta equal to, and this angle is 20 degree. 60 upon sine beta is equal to 270 upon sine 20. So from here beta comes out to be 4.36 degree. Now FC cos beta is equal to F, so FC equal to F upon cos beta, so this will be equal to 2277.23 upon cos of 4.36. So FC will be 2283.84 newton. So this is second part. Now third part is thrust on the cylinder walls. So thrust on the cylinder wall is nothing but FC sine beta. So third part is thrust on cylinder walls, that is equal to FC sine beta. That will be equal to 2283.84 into sine of 4.36. So it will come out to be 173.62 newton. Now fourth part is speed at which the gudgeon pin load is reversed in direction. Gudgeon pin load will be reversed in direction when the net load will be equal to 0. So we have to determine at what speed net load will be 0. So we know that net load is Fp minus Fi plus of Mg. So 0 equal to 51, Fp is 5105 newton minus Fi. Fi we know that mr omega square cos theta plus cos 2 theta upon n, and mg is 1.2 into 9.81. So taking this term on the left hand side, we will get mr omega square into cos theta plus of cos 2 theta upon n equal to 5105 plus of 1.2 into 9.81. So m is 1.2, r is 0.06 into omega square, theta is 20 degree, n is 4.5 equal to 5105 plus 1.2 into 9.81. So from here omega comes out to be 253 radian per second. If we put omega equal to 2 pi n by 60 equal to 253, then speed in rpm comes out to be 2416.3 rpm. So that's it. We will do next question in the next video. Thank you.